Welcome to this stateless Codecast. This is episode number 24 in our series, Getting Started with Rails 7. So I had originally recorded video 23 and this video together in one recording session, but this video was a bit more involved adding action text, especially the testing side of things, than I anticipated. So I decided to split those up. The context of the rest of this video might refer to things that occurred in the previous video, and then the commit at the end of this video will include the changes from both the previous video on the CSS framework and then this code's set of changes. The other thing I want to do for this is make sure that our articles and comments, both of those items have just normal text areas, and Rails has a feature called action text that you can use. Kind of what you see is what you get, rich text editor type thing. So we're going to add that to our articles in the form and for the comments as well. So in order to do that, we need to have the prerequisites installed for active storage. So libvips, I do not think I've got installed, so we'll see what we've got there. So I did a sudo app list, kind of vips with a wildcard character. So we're going to do sudo apt install f. Tools dev libvips 42. Let's see where that gets us. Pause and let this finish. All right, so we've got our item here, stop our server. Action underscore text. So you can see after we did that, so it added to our JavaScript application.js. So app JavaScript application.js, it added in the Trix editor and Rails action text, our import map, got appended to. So if we go to config import map, you can see Trix and Rails action text both got appended there. We created app views, active storage blobs, and then the blob partial, contents, and the content partial. Notes, make sure that image processing gem has been enabled so image uploads will work. Remember to bundle. Our gem file was modified. So you see the the image processing gem was added in. And then we also got the active storage and action text migrations and a fixture for rich texts. So if we go to fixtures, action text, rich texts here, everything's commented out, but it gives an example of the record, kind of using a polymorphic model, the name, and then the body of that. So, and then we have to actually, we'll bundle install first. So now I've got the action text tables, everything, and then for in our article model, we'll add in here rich text body, and then comment, I think we called the attribute body there. Yes, body. So we see how our tests are doing with those changes. So that blew away our invalid article fixture body can't be blank is too short. So all of those body items that we have now need to be moved into that action text, rich texts, YAML item there. So articles, we'll now have so I'll just pause and populate this for a moment. All right, so I've got all of the bodies of those articles and comments moved over to that rich texts YAML, remove the body attribute from the comments and articles fixtures. We'll see what happens. Still have 9 failures and 1 error. Take a look at these. So we've got an error about, I don't understand what you're trying to match in articles controller 28. that difference of the article's body now compared to the active storage, action text version of it. So that's failing. And then we're getting a bunch of errors about the some validation errors, and then some expected versus actual assert equal errors. So what I'll go in and do first is go in and make the text area of these forms a rich text area. So rich text area, and then in comments rich text area. Launch the server back up and see what happens there before. Let's see if this did anything to our tests or if we're still at 9 failures and 1 error. All right, so now I will go in and check on these on the server. New article, we can see that it is a rich text field. Create. Article was successfully created. And we've got, isn't that rich? Well, it saved so though, so it did work there as intended. I'm going to try dragging and dropping an image to see if that is working for us. Seems to have worked. See if it saves and displays. It does. We'll throw in some. Can I throw in text after the picture? Drag and drop, add in the picture, add in a comment here. We've got a comment. With some quote by a person. Let's make sure that destroy still works. It does. Both for the comment and the article. And then let's take a look at our tests now and see what we can do to get those passing. So we've got assertions. So I'm just going to go through these kind of test by test, starting with the models. Comment, got that failure. Article, we've got has valid fixtures is failing. Do we have validation on the comment model? Let me take a look. No, that does not have validation. So the article validates body, presence, true, length, minimum of 10 is not working with the, let me see if changing the order matters. It does not. Let me see what happens if I put in like a one character body in the web application. So the validation doesn't work with the rich text field. So we need to take that out. So we'll go into our article test. Model fixture text should be fine. That should work. Should be invalid when body is blank and body is too short. Are no longer going to be the case. Body validation. See where that gets us on our models. We're down to two failures now. And this is just so now we've got article test and the comment test are both failing on the comparison of plain text to rich text here. So I'm going to throw in a debugger statement to see what I can glean from this right before line 31. action text, rich text, article.body.body. article.body.methods. So there's a two plain text. Yeah, so I think that is what we pop in for those assertions. Gets us down to one. Same deal with comments. See what we're down to overall, excluding our system tests. All right, so that's going to be another two plain text for should create and should update. Since they're shared, I just need to make that one change there. That should knock us down to three failures. Similar on comment, should create. Two failures and an error. Should display errors, should display errors. Title blank and body blank there. Now we're down to one error, articles controller test 28. To plain text, which might not work, but So that gets us back to passing. Now let's run test all. Got a failure and an error in destroying a comment. Broadcasts removes from the page. So let's get to articles test. System. So we're failing on articles test 16 and 68. Fill in body with spam. Let's see what we've got in our So there is body there. So the I need to find the Trix editor here. Fill in body. It will be, let's see if this works. To one failure, line 68, so destroyed comment, broadcasts to article, and removes from page. Line 68. Expected not to find text empty string. So 68 to plain text. Still one failure, still line 68. articles test line 81. So we'll go because the comment body to plain text will no longer be there anymore. Still one failure. Still line 82. Comment body is blank. Maybe I've got an error in my fixture. Comments nerd Ruby. Ruby. Let me go earlier with my debug statement. See what we've got before we destroy it. That is showing as nil there. Let me take a look at the fixture again. Check out the other comments. Thank you. that's got nothing. Got no. Plain text here. It's got a record ID, but it's got no body there. That's odd. I wonder if it's a caused by the existence of the database column and the rich text. Let's see what happens here. If I try to remove the migration. Migrate. Duplicate column name. Oh, some remove. Normal tests passing. Body is still showing up as nil. I guess I can just solve it by creating a new comment instead of using an existing fixture here. So go to articles, test, I've already got an article, I Codecast. I might not even need to do that. Take out debugger and see. If that solves it for us. Okay, yeah, we'll just make it 2. There. Rails test all. Oh, we've got a failure. Format this in a similar way. That's strange that it passed once and failed the second time. They seem to be inconsistent. Maybe it's just time to reboot my machine. But I think we'll call this a win. That's a lot of change. Thank you. write our commit message. All right, we've got our commit message. We will close saved. Everything was saved. Push to the remote, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.